Hello everyone, wishing you all a blissful day. So today we will discuss chapter 5, that is morphology of flowering plants. So it has been divided into 4 main parts, and afterwards at the end of this class we will have the NCERT quick revision also. So the first portion, as you can see here, it is regarding the root, stem, leaf and inflorescence. First we will learn about root, stem, leaf and inflorescence. Then afterwards we will learn about the flower, the instigation, placentation, etc. we will learn. Then fruit and seed. Root and seed formation we will learn. Then the plant families. We will learn about plant families, Fabaceae, Solanaceae and Liliaceae. And afterwards, at the end of the part, we will have the NCERT quick revision. As we have studied in the previous class regarding the Ernest Mayr, in this chapter we will learn about Catherine Esau. Catherine Esau, she was born and brought up in Ukraine. Okay, she was born and brought up in Ukraine. And she has written a book named as Anatomy of Seed Plant. Okay, Anatomy of Seed Plants. It is considered as an encyclopedia. Webster's of Plant Biology. It is considered as encyclopedia. 1960 she has published it. And here, curly top virus. This is spread through phloem. So, curly top virus. This is spread through phloem. Conducting tissues, phloem. Here, you can see the morphology of the flowering plant. The image of the morphology of the flowering plant. So, it consists of root, it consists of stem, it consists of leaf, it consists of flower, it consists of fruit and seed. So these many parts. Let us see the flower area. You can see here the fruit, stem, leaf. So all these together. So node, you can see here node. This portion is known as internode, and this is the bud that which is being fertilized. And here the primary root, secondary root. This form the root system, and the above part form the shoot system. So this form the root system, and the above part form the shoot system. So this is the morphology of a flowering plant. Now let us learn about the root. Where is this root formed from? From the radical part. Okay, shoot is formed from the plumule part. So root, we will learn about the root. It is being divided into three: tap root, fibrous root and adventitious root. Tap root, fibrous root and adventitious root. So we can see here, tap root, it is found most of the dicot plants. We can see the tap root, most of the dicot plants. Example is mustard seed. And the second one, second type of fibrous root, we can find in the monocot plant. And example is wheat plant. And adventitious type of root we can find in the banyan tree, monstrandum. Okay, we can find. So that's also found in the monocot type of adventitious root is found in the monocot. Okay, so example is grass, monstra, banyan, etc. So hope this you have understood. Now let's learn about the modification of the taproot. So the modification of the taproot. So before moving to the modification, taproot. What is taproot? That is a direct elongation of the radical. So primary, lateral, secondary, tertiary root is being arise from that. And fibrous root, that is from arise from the base of the stem. Adventitious root, other than the radical, that is arise from the other than the radical part. So I will be showing you the image of these three types of roots. Now moving towards the modification of the roots. So tap root is being modified to food storage. Okay, so in the carrot we can see conical type of root. In the turnip we can see napiform type of root. And sweet potato, adventitious, tuberous type of root. Asparagus we can see fasciculated type of root. Here in the case of this root, fibrous root, it is being modified to support. So two types of root are found mainly in this one, crop root as well as stilt root. So banyan tree, maize, sugar cane. So banyan tree, maize and sugar cane. Banyan tree, we can see the prop root. So that is pillar like root, a special type of root. And maize and sugar cane, we can see stilt root. That is supporting root. Okay, stilt root is otherwise termed as supporting root. Then here the third one, adventitious root, is being modified to respiration. So pneumatophores, many minute pores are found. So it is known as pneumatophore. And we can see the example here: rhizophora, mangrove plants, and halophytes. Okay, we can see the example. So say these are the main modifications. Now here roots. Here in this one, roots from the lower node. Roots will be rising in the fibrous root from the lower nodes. Now let us learn about the main function of the root. Okay, what are the main function of the root? We know that nodes and internodes are absent in the root. Nodes and internodes are absent in the root. So here, what are the main function? Absorption of water and minerals. Absorption of water and minerals provided proper anchorage to the plant parts. So it will be providing proper anchorage, so attached to the substrate, and it stores reserve food material. So it will be storing the reserve food material. Then it will be synthesized of PGR. What is PGR? Plant growth regulators. So the main function of the root, you have to remember, that is absorption of water and minerals, and they will be providing anchorage to the plant parts, and they will be storing the reserve food material that which is necessary for the root, and synthesis of PGR. PGR is plant growth regulators. As I have told you just now, we will see the images of the taproot, fibrous root, and the adventitious root. The first one is the taproot. See, you can see here from the main root, primary root, secondary root, lateral root is being arise. From the main root is being arise. As I have told you, in the fibrous root, from the base of the stem, you can see here from the base of the stem, the roots are being evolved. And here, adventitious type of root, other than primule, so the roots will be arising from the different, other than the primule, the roots will be arising from the various parts. So this is tap root, fibrous root, and the adventitious root. Now let us see the phases of growth in the root. So here you can see the maturation region. Maturation region. What is the function of maturation region? Function is to absorb water and minerals. That is the main function of the maturation region. Here you can see the maturation region. Then what is the function of the root here? It will be absorbing the water. Okay, what is the function of the root hair? It will be absorbing the water. And epidermal hair are also arised from the root hairs. So, region of maturation. So, epidermal hairs are also arised from the region of maturation, root hairs. And here you can see elongation region. As the name indicates, it will be increasing the length of the root. Here the meristematic region. Division is taking place. Maximum growth will be taking place in the meristematic region. Here you can see the root cap. This is the root cap. So here, this root cap, this is living. Okay, this is living. These are absent in the water plants. Okay, these are absent in the water plants, root cap. Why? Because they have a special adaptation in the water that is not necessary. The root cap is not necessary for those hydras in the water plant. Okay, hope you might have understood what is maturation region, elongation region, meristematic region, root cap, and root hairs. So, maturation region, here what is happening? They are absorbing the minerals, they are absorbing the water, they are absorbing the minerals. Elongation region, increasing the length. Meristematic region, maximum growth is being taken place. Root cap is the living portion, and root hairs, which is arising from the region of maturation, and it is epidermal hairs. Epidermal hairs is arised from the region of maturation. Now let us see the phases of growth. Phases of growth in the meristematic region, elongation, maturation. So in the meristematic, maximum growth will be taking place. Elongation, growth of root in length. So increase in the length. Here maturation, they will be region of maturation, as I have told you, they are absorbing the water and minerals. So now each one we will see in details. First, in the phases of growth, first we will see the root cap. So it is a thimble-like structure. We call it as thumb-like structure. Okay, thimble-like structure. I have shown you the image of the root cap. So these are living. First point you have to remember is that root cap are living and thimble-like structure. It will be protecting the tender part of the root. Root ke jo naju portion se protect kar dete hain. and in hydrophytes, especially in the plants like hydrophytes. So in the plants of water plants and all, this root cap will be absent. So for the water plants, they don't need this root cap. And the next one, we are moving towards the meristematic. So where is it found? It is found just above the root cap. It will be found just above the root cap. Meristematic, we know that it is small, it is thin, it is thin ball, dense protoplasm will be present. So meristematic cell, we know that maximum division will be taking place in the meristematic cell. And the large conspicuous nuclei. So isme nuclei jo hai large hote hain. Okay, then cell wall made up of only primary wall. Cell wall is made up of primary wall. Then cell wall is thin, cellulosic with plasmodesmata connection. They will be having plasmodesmata connection. And next we are moving towards the elongation region. So when it reaches to the max proximal, then elongation region. So they will be absorbing the minerals. Enlarging of the cells, rapid elongation and enlargement is taking place here. Then increased vacuolation, deposition of the new cell wall material. Cells of this region will be gradually increased. Okay, so cells of this region will be gradually increased and differentiate and mature. Okay, it is differentiated region and it is mature region. Now we will learn the region of maturation. So it is genetically controlled hote hain. Phir maturely differentiated cells. Okay, it is differentiated cells and maximum size in terms of cell wall thickening and plasmodesmatic protoplasmic modification. Then xylem and phloem differentiation is taking place here, and root hair will be forming epidermal cells. We have learned it is fine and delicate. We have learned and thread like structure. They will be absorbing the water and minerals, which is the region that is region of maturation. Hope these three is clear to you all. So what all the things are taking place in the meristematic, in the root cap, meristematic region, elongation, and in the maturation phase. So all these will be taking place. Now moving forward. Now let us see the function of the stem. Stem, as I have told you, it is raised from the plumule. Okay, root is evolved from the radical, and stem will be evolved from the plumule region. So as you can see here, nodes and internodes are present in the stem, and buds are there. It has terminal as well as axillary axis. And what are the main functions of the stem? First of all, spreading out branches, bearing leaves, flowers, and fruit. So spreading out branches, bearing leaves, flowers, and fruit. Then conducts water, minerals, and photosynthesis. So photosynthesis is mainly taking place. Storage of food, support, protection, all these are the function. Then vegetative propagation may be come aate hain. Okay, so spreading out branches, bearing leaves, flowers, and fruits. Photosynthesis is taking place here. Conducting water of minerals, storage of the food. It supports, it protects, and vegetative propagation also. So these are the main functions of the stems. So now let's see the modification of the stems. So first modification is food storage. Okay, first modification is food storage. Here underground stem. Okay, underground stem, it will be acting as organ of perennation. That means even if the unfavorable condition occurs there, even if fire is there in that particular place and all, nothing will happen. It cannot destroy it. Okay. So potato, examples are potato, ginger, turmeric, zameenkand, colocasia. Okay, these are all. So even in the unfavorable condition, they will grow, they will survive. Okay, in the adverse condition also, they will be able to survive. Next is of stem tendrils. The next modification is stem tendrils. So it helps the plants to climb. So it is derived from the axillary bud. So tendrils is derived from the axillary buds. So examples we are having here, gourds, cucumber, pumpkins, watermelon, all these are tendrils. So they are helping the plant to climb out. Grapevine, pea, all these are the examples of stem tendrils. The next one is thorns. The important thing that which you have to remember in the thorns is that they will be protecting the plant from the browsing of the animals. They will be protecting the plant from the browsing of the animals. So since there is thorn, the animals may not go and graze over it, isn't it? So these type of plants may be woody, straight. Okay, and from axil buds, they will be having thorns. So they are straight. For examples, we have citrus and bougainvillea. They are very, very familiar to these two plants, citrus and bougainvillea. Both of these are having thorns. So animals don't attack. So it saves, protects the plants from that. That's the special type of adaptation. Next is phylloclade. So it is mainly for the photosynthesis. Photosynthesis. So it is phylloclade is being divided into two. They are flat and cylindrical. Flat, Opuntia, cylindrical, Euphorbia is the example. And they are found in the arid regions. That means in the desert region we can find these things. Then the next one is that offset. Next modification is offset. So offset of leaves, tufts of root on each node. Okay, so here the rosette of leaves, tufts of root in each node we can find out. Okay, so short in the node. Examples are Pistia and Hyporia. What a chaos in the node. Okay, that is offset. And here sucker, runner and stolon are very, very important. Sucker, these will be formed from the node of the underground stem. Sucker is formed from the node of the underground stem. How does it grow? It grows horizontally beneath the soil. Then only, first it will be growing in this way, then only they will be growing obliquely. First growing in the horizontal way, then growing obliquely. So examples of suckers, we can say banana is one of the examples, pineapple is another example, chrysanthemum is another example, mint is another example. So these are all the examples. So it will be upward, afterwards obliquely when it comes, it will be coming to the leafy shoot in the form of leafy shoots. So hope sucker is also clear to you. Now next is runner. Runner, older parts will be dying and new plants will be formed here. What are the examples? Grass, cynodon and coxsackie is another example. Then stolon. Next part is stolon. So stolon we have the examples, jasmine, strawberry, vallisneria are the examples of the stolon. Next we have here rhizome, ginger and turmeric. So here the rhizomes will be growing horizontal way. Okay, ginger, turmeric, we have the examples here. Then the bulb. It is stems are modified into bulb. How? Onion and garlic, we can say. So it will be having fleshy leaves. Okay, stems are highly reduced in this one and they will be having the fleshy leaves. So these are the modification of the stems. Food storage, first it is modified into food storage, then stem tendrils. Examples we have the thorns, phylloclade, offset, then sucker, runner, stolon, then the rhizome and the bulb. So here are some of the images of what I have taught you just now. Ginger is here, zameenkand. So potato, you are all very familiar with this one. As I have told you, the axillary modified into tendrils. So axils are modified into tendrils to climb. Okay, auxiliary species is here. You can see the roots, how it is being raised. And the bougainvillea, stem is modified into spines. So here the thorns. So to protect from the animals. Next, we are going to learn about the leaf, structure of the leaf is here. So this portion is fully known as lamina. You can see here, lamina. And this is the petiole region. And here, this is petiole. And axillary bud is being raised from here. This is the leaf base. And these are the stipules. Okay, so this is the structure of leaf. So this whole area is termed as lamina. So now we have seen the image of the leaf. Okay, so what are the main function, most important vegetative organ is leaf. So photosynthesis is taking place. So leaf is a flattened structure. It is arranged in an appropriate order. Then axillary bud arise and branches are being arise from the leaf. So it is being divided into three. They are leaf base, petiole and lamina. Or we can call it as leaf blade. Okay, leaf base, petiole and lamina. So in the leaf base, we can see stipules and lateral small leaf-like structure. Then most probably it is found in the monopod. Leaf base will be leaf base expands in the monopods into the sheath covering the stem and partially or wholly here the leaf base is being arranged in that way. Then petiole, it will be just bending the niche portion, whole blade to the light. Okay, so niche dendrika motion is equal to the petiole. So it flutters in the wind. Leaf blade will be fluttering in the wind. So it provides cooling surface, then bring fresh air to the leaf surface. So this these are the main functions of the petiole. Lamina, which is otherwise termed as leaf blade. So main veins, midrib, and vein. We can see that veins, midribs, and veinlets are all in the lamina. Okay, these three things you can see. They will be providing rigidity to the lamina and channel of transport of water, minerals, food materials, etc. So photosynthesis is mainly taking place here. So leaf is being divided into three: base, petiole, and lamina. So here, the growth of leaf primordium. They are first arise from the apical, then from the marginal. So that's about the leaf. So leaf shows two types of venation. Types of leaf shows two types of venation. One is reticulate venation, that is in dicot, and parallel venation, that is in monocot. You can see here the image. So this is reticulate type of venation. So here you can see the network of, and this is the parallel type of venation. Okay, this is the parallel type of venation. So here types of the leaves is being divided into simple, axis of petiole, simple and compound. Okay, so the types of leaves, it is divided into two main parts. They are simple and compound. So in the simple one, so incisions don't touch the midrib. Incisions will not touch the midrib. So entire lamina is pinnately compound. Okay, pinnately. Okay, pinnately compound here and palmately compound. Compound is of two types: pinnately as well as palmately. So here pinnately means leaf that's not on the branches. Okay, so example we have here neem, and palmately means leaf that's attached at the tip of the petiole. So common at the common point leaves will be attached. So example is of silk cotton. So the differences between the types of leaves, two types of leaves, simple as well as compound, we have learned dicot and the monocot. The incision will not be touching the midrib. The entire lamina, the incisions will not be touching the midrib with the simple leaf. Okay, the compound leaf is divided into two. They are pinnately as well as palmately compound. Leaf pinnately compound, what is the peculiarity? Leaflets will not be touching the branches. So leaflets are not on the branches. Here the leaflets attached to the tip of the petiole. So examples we have here neem, and here we have silk cotton. So here is the image of pinnately compound and palmately. So this is the leaf of silk cotton, and here we have branches. See here branches, as I have told you just now. Next we will learn about the phyllotaxy. What is phyllotaxy? The arrangement of the leaves. How the leaves are being arranged? Alternate, opposite, and dual type of arrangement. Alternate, opposite, and dual type. In the alternate, single leaf will be arising from the each node. So we will see the image. Examples: China rose, mustard, sunflower. We have. And opposite, a pair of leaves arise at each node. So we have example here: Calatropis and Gua. Okay, Calatropis and Gua are the examples of the opposite. Then a bolt. Okay. More than two leaves arise at each node. That is, Alstonia is the example. So when you see the images, then it will be more clear to you. Here we have the example of China rose. That is alternate arrangement. You can see here the alternate leaves will be arising on different. See here, just opposite. So in the opposite case, we have learned in the case of Gua. In the next, we are going to learn the old type. See, which is in the old type. It is attached to the petiole. Now let us learn some of the modifications of the leaf. So here we have the modifications of the, some of the leaves are being modified into tendrils to climbing P. In the wild P, I don't you can see this spine. The next one is spine, that is for the defense. So in the cacti and opuntia we can see this type of food storage. Next modification is food storage. Examples we have onion and garlic. So fleshy leaves they will be having. And they will be having the fleshy leaves are reduced too. Okay, stems are reduced and they will be having fleshy leaves here in the case of onion and garlic. Next, petiole performs photosynthesis. So example is Australian acacia. So it will be having phyllode. So leaves will be small and it is short-lived. And next modification is to trap the insect. So we have seen the pitcher plant, insectivorous plant. Okay, nepenthes, and in the case of bladderwort and all, this particular plant will be capturing the insects, preying over the insects, and Venus flytrap. we have earlier also we have learned. And next modification, the mills. Okay, it is in the form of Spadix cabalamus. Then it is in the Caryopsis and in the Silky Hairs. These are the modification that which is taking place in the mills. In the Silky Hairs here, they will be having styla or stigma. Okay. So next we will learn about the inflorescence. So what is inflorescence? What do you mean by inflorescence? So if any of the floral axes they arrange here, then it is inflorescence. If it is arranged in any of the floral axes, then it is termed as inflorescence. So there are two types of inflorescence here: racemose type of inflorescence and cymose types of inflorescence. Okay, in the racemose types, we know that main axis continues to grow. So flowers will be in acropital manner. What do you mean by acropital manner? In this one, the old flower will be on the lower side and the young flower will be on the upper side. And here it will be cymose main axis will be terminating into a flower. So here in the basipetal order, basipetal manner the flower arrangement is. What is basipetal order? The old flower will be on the upper side and the young flower will be on the lower side. So just opposite of it. Okay, so is it clear to you? Inflorescence are of two types, racemose and zygote. Okay, then here the edible part of the cauliflower, we know that cauliflower, we had the edible part of the cauliflower, that is also termed as inflorescence. And here we have hypanthodium, that is a special type of inflorescence, hypanthodium. So there we have male type, female and sterile one. Okay, male, female and sterile. We have examples, ficus is one of the example. Fig tree is another example, banyan tree is another example, peepal tree is another example for this hypanthodium. Hypanthodium is a special type of inflorescence. So we can find male, female and sterile type of inflorescence here. And here the sunflower is also another example for the inflorescence. We can see the image of the inflorescence, racemose type of inflorescence. See? And cymose type of inflorescence. The old flower will be on the top and the young flower will be beneath. Here in the case of this one, young flower will be on the upper side and old flower will be on the lower side. One more images you can see here. The racemose type of inflorescence and the cymose type of inflorescence. You can see here the young buds growing on the upper side. Here the old flowers growing on the lower side. Is it clear? So today we have seen the leaf structure of root, different various types of roots and its modification. Then the stem we have seen, its example and its modification we have seen. Then leaf, its modification we have seen, an example we have learned, and inflorescence, different various types of inflorescence. So that's all for today, and tomorrow we will learn about the flower. Okay, so tomorrow we will learn about the part 2. This was about part 1. So this is root, stem, leaf and inflorescence. So tomorrow we will learn about the flowery situation and all. Okay, thank you for listening me. Learn at home properly, go through your NCERT text, underline the important points, learn, make a note, prepare notes. May God bless you all. Thank you.